Hello everyone, JC here. One series I'd like to do are things that I've learned about Power Automate since I've started using it a bit more at work, and throw some tips and tricks out, gotchas, that kind of stuff. The first one I'd like to cover is a situation I ran into, tripped me up for a couple minutes. I had a condition that was always evaluating to false, even though it looked like it should be evaluating to true, at least in certain circumstances. So if you're running into that, you might be running into the problem that I had, which was having a string data type instead of a Boolean data type and comparing it to true or false. So I'll run through what that looks like, create a flow that fails, and show you how to fix it. So we'll just go in here, create a new instant flow. Initialize a variable. Another variable. Oh, one thing I like to do on all of my variables is I always rename this to whatever the name of my variable is. I mean, it's probably completely unnecessary, but it helps me a little bit. Right, so then we're going to go down here and just add a condition. That condition is going to check string condition. String condition is equal to true. Set variable, check result, set to true. If no, do the same thing, although this will be completely unnecessary because it's already false. So that literally will not do anything, but these don't even really matter what we're doing here. So, all right, so what do we think this flow is going to do? All right, we're setting a string value to the word, to the string value of true. We have a variable to store the result of our condition. In our condition, we're comparing string condition is equal to true. We have true there, we have true there. So we should hit this path over here. It's equal to true. If yes, we're going to set our check result variable to true. It's currently false. All right, so go up here to test. Test our flow, run it. All right, so come down here and we see that it evaluated the false path. So the result of our expression was false. Why is that? Well, the problem is that this, when you set this to true, you've set a string data type, it's assuming that the input that you put here is a string. So apparently in the background that is getting wrapped in quotes as we would expect. So down here, when you compare string condition is equal to true, this is not a string, apparently. This is getting evaluated to or automatically turned into a Boolean in the background. So there are two ways to fix this. One, we can change this to a string, put this in quotes, save it, test, run our flow, And now we see that it evaluated to true and took this branch. The other way to fix that, and this is, I would consider this to be the proper way if you're just checking for true or false values, is to keep this to true with no quotes, and then change our condition variable to a Boolean. So if we switch this, actually I'm gonna leave that and just do a new variable. This one will do a Boolean, set that to true, and then this will be Boolean condition. And we're going to come down here, change this to Boolean condition is equal to true. Save that, test it. And we see that it evaluates to true and takes the if yes branch. So anytime you're comparing just on true or false and don't actually need to compare against a string value of some sort, you should always initialize your variable as a Boolean type and don't use a string type, because one, I think it's much more clear about what you're doing with this variable. If it's a Boolean, we know that it can only be one of two values. If it's a string, it could be almost anything. So that's one reason to pick a Boolean. And the other is that it eliminates some of those little gotchas that you might run into otherwise. So I hope that this helps somebody. Like I said, it tripped me up for a couple minutes.